My name is Brian Hawkins. I'm a research associate professor at Duke University in the Center for Wash Aid. The Center for Wash Aid, as the name implies, we're focused primarily on water and sanitation. We're particularly interested in applications for improving sanitation and also for encouraging water reuse. A lot of our work in sanitation means we're working with things people do not want to work with. We work with feces, we work with urine, we work with the byproducts of those things. There's, at least to my knowledge, nothing that fully mimics the mechanical properties of feces, which are somewhat unique. Certainly nothing that mimics the mechanical properties and the biological properties of what goes into feces. It's going to sound simplistic, but the reality is it sticks to everything. It's very hard to move, and anything mechanical that touches it, you have to understand how it's going to fail when you're handling a sticky, hard-to-move material. So our ability and our willingness to do that, and we try to do it at the earliest possible stages of development, I think helps us move faster and develop things that are actually going to work. There's definitely a sense of urgency in climate, in water resources, and that really drives a lot of what I do and what I think a lot of what we do here. You can just watch the news on any given week and you will see crises that are happening that are a function of inadequate water resources or inadequate infrastructure to deal with waste and water. We have developed a system that's fairly compact, about the size of a hot water heater for a household, and it can treat all of the wastewater that comes out of a toilet or a couple of toilets to a point where it's safe for non-potable reuse. So you wouldn't want to drink it, but it's perfectly safe to flush the toilet with. You could use it for irrigation. It could potentially even be used for cooling applications. And so the idea here is that the water doesn't have to leave the home, doesn't have to be transported to the home. It's just being continually reused on site in a way that saves a lot of money on transport costs, on plumbing, on infrastructure. So, for example, in the United States, about a quarter of the potable water that comes into homes is flushed down the toilet. And we think that's not necessary. You don't need potable water to flush your toilets. If you expand that and start using treated water on site for things like laundry or irrigation, depending on where you live, you could eliminate up to 76% of your potable water use. So that would be really important for water-stressed areas. So we're working on some technologies that are very specifically targeted at pulling nitrogen and phosphorus out of water that's already been treated to a certain point by a septic system or an advanced treatment system, and getting that last little bit of nitrogen and phosphorus out before it goes into the environment. An ongoing concern about the entry of nitrogen and phosphorus into watersheds, this can lead to harmful algal blooms, which cause fish die-offs, make the water generally nasty. Climate change is definitely a driver in our work. The availability, the quantity, and the quality of water resources, I think, are really one of the areas in which the effects of climate change will be felt most acutely around the world. When droughts happen, it affects the water. When floods happen, it affects the water. Really, you have to be able to manage water resources. You have to be able to provide clean water. And that really touches on a lot of the things we work on. Climate change is happening now. It's not happening 10 or 20 years in the future. It's happening right